Hey guys, this is Eskimo Poodle, and we are back with Let's Play Demon's Souls on Sony PlayStation 3. Last time, we did a little bit of weapon upgrading with Blacksmith Ed over in Stonefang Tunnels, and then we also progressed just a little bit into Stonefang Tunnels Part 2 in order to get this guy, Patches a Hyena, to show up in order to get some stuff from him. So that took a little longer than I expected, actually, but oh well, we got what we came for. And now we're finally going to head out to the fourth world, which is a very nice world, in my opinion. Before we go over there, you're going to want to bring a couple of things with you. You don't have to, but it's you're going to get some stuff if you do. So first things, you want to bring one Augite of Guidance. By the way, each of these things, you only need one of them. So if I happen to have more for some reason, then oops. But you only need one of each of them. So you need a Augite of Guidance there. You need, let's see, a shard of Mercury Stone. If you have a chunk of Mercury Stone, that's also good too. You can bring both of them. A shard and a chunk of Moonlight Stone. Let's see, what else we need here? If you still have the Jade Hair Ornament, you can bring that along. And that actually gives you something different than what I thought it did. The Brass Telescope, bring that along too, because you can use that for something. I think the Brass Telescope's actually with this guy. The Brass Telescope is the item that gets you the Fragrant Ring, which regenerates your MP. I thought, for some reason, I was thinking it was the Jade Hair Ornament, but it's the Brass Telescope. I'm probably not going to get it since I don't really need it. But if you have a magic character and need MP regeneration, bring that item along. Let's see. Some other stuff that I got with me was, let's see here, a silver cornet and silver bracelets. Those are both going to be traded in. If you happen to have an extra Talisman of God, bring that along with you too. I don't have an extra Talisman of God, but I'll live. And how is my item burden? Ooh, 81. There's got to be a couple things I can drop here.
Hello again.
Let's get rid of some of this stuff. We don't need all this, we don't need the hard stone stuff or the sharp stone stuff with us right now. I just happened to have that from last episode, I think. The clear stone stuff, we can put that away. Gray stone, dragon stone, we can put that stuff away. Okay, shard of Mercury Stone, keep that. The weapons are good, arrows are good. Let's see, everything else is good over there. And all right, all the rings are good.
You have a heart of gold.
I think we checked on the upgrades at the end of last episode as well. So let's just go ahead and make our way into the fourth area here. The Archstone of the Shadowman. The island shrine of the Shadowmen, who worship storms and mourn the dead. Here, the storm beasts fly above, and the souls of the dead inhabit empty skeletons and move about freely. Oh, by the way, make sure you have your thief's ring equipped, because enemies in this area have a very long range. But it's probably most people's favorite area. It's my favorite area. And you'll find out why as soon as we get a little way into it. If the loading screen ever decides it wants to hurry up. Alright. So here we are in 4-1. The Shrine of Storms. See those things flying around out there? Yeah, watch out. Those aren't just set pieces. They will attack you. And then we get our first enemy right up there. A skeleton with a sword. Those guys have reasonably long range, so you want to be careful about them. I hear that these guys are actually weak to blunt weapons, but I'm not actually entirely sure how weak they are to it, so I never actually bothered using blunt weapons on them, but I'm going to try this time. Alright, so let's go ahead and get close to this guy here. He should find us. There we go. Yeah, these guys like to roll towards you real fast like that. And If they are really weak to blunt. Okay, that's really good. Wow, that worked out really well. But yeah, you're going to run into a couple of pairs of these guys, and if they're both rolling at you and you're trying to block them and trying to attack at the same time, it's not going to work out too well because they roll around really fast, and they'll catch up to you even if you try to run all the way back here. So yeah, they're little rat bastards, and they're not really all that fun to deal with. I still think these brass knuckles just look like a ironing iron or something like that, but that's just my opinion. Anyways, let's go ahead and go over here. See, half moon grass, very nice, I like it. And let's go ahead and get this guy to attack us. Let's see how much damage we do with our piercing pole or spear here. Let's see, we're doing 100 per hit with our knuckles. Yeah, so 70-ish per hit. Yeah, the blunt definitely makes up for it. You know what? I don't think I've ever... I don't think we've seen our counterattack for this, but he seems to be stuck there. Alright, come on. Okay, the power attack of that guy. Ah, dang. Okay, how about you target the guy down here, not the guy up there? Yeah, that guy up there, he's kind of a pain in the ass. Usually, when you fight him, though, usually I don't target him from all the way down here, but I got lucky this time. Ooh, and we get shards of blade stone in this level. I think we also get chunks of blade stone. And pure blade stone is a very rare drop in this area. And then blade stone is the dexterity upgrade, where it gets rid of the strength bonus and powers up your dexterity bonus. Okay, so for this guy right here, he is an archer. So you want to just go ahead and just pelt them from a distance here. Luckily, the archers don't have all that much HP, so that makes life easy. And then let's go ahead and draw this guy out. There we go. And by the way, when they roll around like that, I think their spikes on their bodies actually can do a little bit of damage to you, so be careful about that. They're just bastard enemies all around. And you know what? Might want to heal up here. Ooh! We got lucky on our first drop. These guys drop holy arrows, which deal magic damage. They're rare, so you're not going to get them very often. But if they do drop them, awesome. Usually they drop something else, which they'll probably drop at some point. There we go. Ooh, damn, that did a ton of damage. 377, nice. Okay, I'm getting really lucky with these Bladestone drops, because the last time I went through here, all they dropped was their other item, which is useful for about one thing, really. Actually, I guess they're kind of useful for other stuff, but I never use them. And why am I doing more damage all of a sudden? Huh, that's weird. Instead of doing 100 damage, I'm doing 140. But, okay, I guess blunt really does do a very nice job here. Okay, let's go ahead and get our bow. And get rid of these guys. Because otherwise they'll try to pelt you with arrows on the way down. And that's just not fun. By the way, I don't think the arrows that they fire are actually holy arrows or anything like that. I think they're just regular arrows, but I'm not entirely sure. So have you noticed anything just from killing these couple enemies on the way up here? How our souls are a nice, decent amount? Yeah, this area is very good for souls. This entire fourth world is just very good for getting souls. You'll typically end the level with, I usually do, around 15 to 20,000 souls, which is really nice for just a nice quick run. So it's very good just for soul farming. And it's a good reason to not come here too early, because you might just end up getting overpowered. Ooh, there's our Talisman of God. That was really fast, actually. I'm probably going to use that for something in this level, and then get a different Talisman of God, since I don't need the Evacuate spell just yet. And I don't have the money, the souls for it anyways. But that's really nice. Let's see, you, Renowned Hero Soul, very nice. And over here we got a Soldier's Lotus, okay, good. We can deal with that. We can't get to this little ledge over here. At least, I don't think we can. I've never actually tried, now that I think about it. Yeah, we can't climb over there, but we'll be able to get there eventually. And despite it showing that it goes around this way, you can't actually just, like, walk around this way. You can, I think you can get out from that way, but you can't get over there. So, oh well. Not that it's really that big of a deal. But let's go ahead and go through the fog gate here. And if you remember from the tutorial, that might look just a little familiar. Yeah, that guy's back, Vanguard. And just like the tutorial, you don't have to kill him if you don't want to. You can just completely ignore him. But I'm going to go ahead and kill him just to get his soul again and his souls. So, might as well. Just be careful, though. He can still be very tough. And it might just be easier just to pelt him with arrows, which is probably what I'm going to end up doing, is just firing at him from a distance. But yeah, he can still be a pain in the ass. And he doesn't really like to move from his spot right there very much. I don't know why. He likes to just kind of sit there. You know what? Let's go ahead and just start pelting him right now. Why not? Yeah, we're actually doing a little more damage than we were doing in the tutorial, but he still has a fair amount of HP, and he's still going to take a decent amount of time to kill. But you know what? Let's actually see how much our holy arrows do since we got them. Let's see. They do 150 magical damage compared to 85 physical damage for the heavy arrows. Let's see. We only got 5, so might as well try them out. Yeah, they don't even do that much extra. But yeah, you could try to melee this guy, but honestly, might as well just arrow him because he's not going to come after you right here, and it's just easier to get it done this way. And you know what? He killed me enough times in the tutorial that I don't really want to get killed by him again, because like I said, he can still one-shot you, especially since the only piece of armor that we've actually upgraded is our helmet. I mean, yeah, our defense is higher, but and our health is higher, but he's still going to do a chunk of damage to us if we get too close to him. So we're just going to make this nice and easy. And actually, he's going down a little faster than I thought he would. Wow, he's going real fast. But yeah, some reason he doesn't come after you. Like, if you try to go close enough, I don't think he'll really go any further than, like, this little section with the barricade of boards, and just like right over there. He's just not really all that keen on moving from there. So, yeah. And good night, sir. Well, that was much less climactic than I thought. And just because he is a demon that gives you a demon soul does not mean that he gives you soul form back. Only bosses ever actually give you soul human form back. Alright, so we got a storied hero soul. Very nice. Nice amounts of souls there. A Kilige, which is another curved sword, which I think is better than the falchion. Yeah, better by about 10 points. And I think it's actually one of the best I think it's one of the better curved swords that you can get without having to worry about like special swords like boss soul swords or like other stuff like that. Let me see here. I think it's because if this is the one that I like, I'll probably just end up using it. Let's see. If it has the good enough stats, then yeah, I'll just use it. Kilige. Yeah, it's pretty much the best one. There is another one that we're gonna use alongside it for purposes, but yeah, this should be fine. And actually, now that I think about it, crikey. I gotta upgrade the dang scimitar to +8 anyways. Eh, I wasn't even paying attention to that. Oh well. Well, I'll worry about all that off screen or in another episode or something. But the falchion should be our new curved sword if we ever need slashing damage. Which I don't really know who all is weak to slashing damage in this level, if there even is anybody that is weak to it. Okay, yeah, these guys right here, be careful about them. This is one of the reasons you want the Thief's Ring equipped, because they can target you from a distance, and it's not going to work out too great for you. And there's a lizard down there, but I'm not too worried about him just yet. Let's see. Yeah, these guys are all flying away. You want to try to kill these guys if you can, because these guys also give a nice chunk of souls. Yeah, 440 souls is for one of them, so really nice. And if you don't kill them, well, I'll just tell you right now, they shoot out a giant spike from their tail that launches at you from halfway across the screen and does a chunk of damage there. And here they drop a cloud stone, which, if I'm not mistaken, I think that does... let's see... cloud stone. I think that does shield upgrades. Yeah, that does shield upgrades. And what it does is it doesn't increase the guard break reduction like the regular upgrade path for shields would, but instead it reduces the magic damage reduction. So you end up with average guard break, but much better magic damage. I'm not going to worry about it since I have a shield in mind that I'm going to use, but it's not a bad path if you don't want like a special shield like I'm planning on going for. Because most of the guard break reduction is decent enough at like 55 or 60, and I don't really care to get it any higher. But the extra magic damage, I think it'll top out at like 70%, I think, is actually really good. Let's see, more shards of cloud stones. And like I said, that's what those guys drop. Yeah, see, that's their attack right there from that guy. And they'll target you from a pretty good distance, too. And they're actually pretty good about dropping cloud stones, but the problem is, if they die over the abyss right there, like the ocean or whatever, you're not going to see that cloud stone that they drop. So, yeah, I'm not too terribly worried about it. Anyways, we picked up a sword. The Uchigatana, which is a katana. I've never actually used the katanas, but I might try them out, actually. They do piercing and slashing damage. But I'm not really sure how good they are. I mean, they're two-handed, obviously, since they're katanas. I think you can wield them in one hand, but I think the effectiveness just isn't all that great. And also, if you notice, this one has very low durability for some reason. 70 durability. That's really low, so I might not even... I mean, I'll try. Yeah, you know what? Let's just put it on just for a little bit here and just give it a few shots, but... Like, I'll use it on a few enemies, but like I said, I think everybody in this level is actually weak to the blunt. Yeah, there we go. It's not a bad weapon, but it's just not... There's better out there, in my opinion. Anyways, let's go ahead and Crescent Moon up real fast. See if we try to two-hand it. Yeah, then we can start doing a nice little two-handed combos there. But... we'll try it out. Actually, not against the next enemy, though, because the next enemy is, another one of those skeleton dudes. Okay, right here, you see that little indentation on the floor? Get your shield up. If you don't, you'll die. Yeah, they shoot up those three crossbolts right there. And while they don't do a whole lot of damage to your shield guard, they will pretty much kill all your health off. Like, they're really powerful for some reason when they actually hit your body instead of your shield. Like, they'll just kill you. Okay, this guy right here, he killed me anyways. That guy is basically the red-eyed knight from the first level, except this guy is not anywhere near as hard. I got unlucky there, but oh well. Now let's go ahead and try the katana on this guy, just for shits and giggles. Okay, he's trying to break my guard. That's not happening. Yeah, it's not doing a whole lot of damage to him, but oh well. I want to try to backstab you there, but you're not letting me. Now, let's just go back to the Knuckles. Yeah, the katana is decent, but eh, it's just not my style. At least not in this game. Like maybe other games I might like katanas, but eh, not this particular one. I just like the regular swords. Alright, good night, sir. More Bladestone, very nice. Alright, you're gonna try to screw me over here, aren't you? I just know you are. By the way, if you kill the Vanguard and then get killed before you collect his soul, it's not going to be there when you come back, and neither is he. So you're just going to be out his soul, pretty much. So you want to be careful about that. You don't want to get too trigger happy before picking up his soul. And I don't know why you'd be so aggressive here. Okay. Yeah, see, these guys, you try to back away to heal, and they'll just screw you over completely. Okay, they finally drop the item that they normally drop, Soul Remains, which supposedly distract enemy attention for a while, but I've never noticed it doing that great of a job. Some people say it does do a good job, but I don't really notice it working all that well. Okay, I'm not trying to die here. I want to get my health up here. Alright, thank you. Okay, now they're dropping all the silver remains. Oh well. Okay, why is my stuff all messed up here? Crescent. Yeah, that's in the wrong spot there. Alright, we need half. Then late. And let's go ahead and put the... just leave it blank for right now. Yeah, see, this is why you want to kill those dang archers before you get over to fight this guy, which I forgot to do this time. Because otherwise they'll just sit over here and pelt your ass with arrows. And that's never any fun. Luckily, they seem to have a short attention span, so they're not going to pester me too much here. Alright, now hopefully they dropped arrows, but it's entirely possible that they just dropped more soul remains, which they seem to be back in the habit of doing now. Let's see, can I bother with you? I'm getting actually really lucky with these shots against these guys, because of the way they fly, and they'll usually fly out of your range, you'll just waste a lot of shots trying to actually hit the dang things. I'm getting really lucky actually hitting them today, but usually they waste a lot more of my arrows than this. And they're definitely going to waste more of my arrows than later arrows, areas of the level, that's for sure. Okay, let's try this again here. Let's try not to die right away. And actually, you know what? Let me put on my spear just for range if I need it. But I want to try to knuckle up this guy. He's not too bad, as just his attacks aren't very powerful. Like he's not like extra Roy like the guys downstairs. Okay, he doesn't seem to be as weak to blunt as his buddies. Or maybe I'm just getting luckier. Yeah, he's reasonably weak to blunt, but not that much. I think he just has better defense overall. You can backstab this guy, and that'll do a decent chunk of damage. But his attacks just do so much guard break and damage overall that he's got to be really careful with them. Okay, that's not being careful. Oh, I thought that was a backstab right there. Alright, let's see if I can't knuckle up the last couple damage points here. Alright, got him. Very good. Yeah, really powerful there. But worth a decent amount of souls, so that's always nice. Alright, we got a Crescent Falchion here, right? Let's see, Crescent... Oh, this is the other magic upgrade path that you can go... for magic, not for faith. This one adds magic damage to the weapon, and it makes it so your damage scales with the magic stat, and it also adds MP regeneration alongside that, and it completely eliminates the dexterity and strength bonuses, so it's pure magic based. But yeah, just the MP regeneration alone is actually really good, because let's see, I think it goes to like 5 or 6 MP per second. It goes to a reasonably decent amount. Excuse me. And if you pair it up with like the ring that the royals start out with, the royalty, then, well, you're going to have very nice MP regeneration. Let's see. I guess it doesn't say. But if you go the Moonlight Stone upgrade, then it'll be like a E and an E scaling in Strength and Dexterity, and a C scaling over in Magic. Whereas with the Crescent, it's a straight A scaling that slightly improves at all levels. So, yeah, the Crescent path is definitely the way to go over the Moon stat, the Moon one, unless you just have like a very average Magic stat. Trying to figure out how much the MP regeneration actually does for Crescent. I know it's a decent amount, but I'm not finding any hard numbers here. Oh, here it is. Okay, what it is it's plus +1 mana regen over a period of every couple seconds. So, like, the first two levels is plus one mana regen every 5 seconds. At levels 3 and 4, it's plus +1 mana regen every 4 seconds. And at level 5, it's plus +1 mana regen every 3 seconds. So it's not that big of a deal, but if you power it up, or combine it with the Fragrant Ring, then you get a nice, steady little supply of your MP back. And you're probably not going to have to worry about spices all that much. Okay, more soul remains, which I don't really need. And I don't think there's anything else up here. Yeah, there's nothing else up here. So let's go ahead and get out of here. But yeah, that's definitely the way you want to go for your magic-based weapons. And since you find a free falchion right here, Crescent Falchion right here, yeah, might as well use it if you have the magic stat to go with it, or to make it worthwhile. All right, let's keep our sword up, or shield up here, because this guy, he likes to be right here. Okay, obviously the power attack on that just is not worth it, since it just totally sucks. Did you drop arrows, or is it more... it's more solar maze. That's what I figured. And down here, I don't think there's a whole lot we can do down here. And we want to be careful of that pressure plate right there. See, a copper key. That'll be useful for, well, the next part of the level that we're going to. And how is... Okay, yeah. Okay, yeah, that'll be useful for the next part that we're... Or maybe the part after next. Well, it'll be useful coming up in this level. Let's just put it that way. I see a nice little body over there, but we can't get to it just yet. Let's see. Let's go... No, let's go down here real fast. Oh, never mind. I was thinking of a different path. Never mind. Let's go over here. And let's go ahead and get this guy before he gets us. Alright. No, he didn't drop anything. He didn't drop any arrows or anything. I guess this could be another good spot where if you wanted to snipe a Vanguard down there, you could probably do it pretty easily from up there, but from where I showed you, still safe anyways. Alright, this guy, let's go ahead and clobber him, shall we? Alright, there should be... another guy. Alright, we're not going to worry about here yet. By the way, it's a hidden passage. There we go. We're not going to worry about that just yet. We're going to go over here. Which is where you get some really nice stuff from this level. Well, that guy, he likes to roll down the stairs and be confused as to why you're not there when he does roll down. Yeah, that guy gets a little over-eager sometimes. But anyways, if you go over here, this is where the archer skeleton was attacking you if he had any items on him. And he's guarding a compound longbow, which is going to be the bow that I'm going to be using for the rest of the game, because it has the highest base attack power of a bow, I think by like 5 points over the compound short bow. But, yeah, it has the best overall stats. And then we get light arrows, which, honestly, I'm not sure. I think those are just the same as regular arrows. Yeah, 70 damage. I don't know. Oh, I guess they have a slightly longer distance. But, I'm still going to stick with the heavy arrows just for the power. And let's see. Let's go ahead and see how the compound longbow is doing there. Let's see. Hey, it's not. It's a little weaker right now, but you know what? I think I'll live. We're going to upgrade it very soon, anyways. So, actually, no, I think I'll stick with the short bow for now until I do upgrade the compound longbow. But yeah, I think the compound short bow has a base attack of 40, whereas compound longbow has 45. So it's a slight upgrade, but it's enough to make a difference. Okay, anyways, let's go over here, back down, actually over here, yeah. Okay, this is where he jumped down at us, and we want to go up this path right here, because this path has some good stuff for us. Like a dead body. I got guidance, okay, we could use one of those. Hey, can I get this guy, or is he going to be too far away? Oh, well. We'll worry about him later.
You scary, give Sparky me. Give Twinkly me. Me. You. Trade. Give me Sparky Twinkly.
Okay, so there is a crow up there, and he wants Sparkly, Twinkly, Shiny stuff. This is Sparkly the Crow. I don't think he has an actual name, but that's what everyone calls him. And
you.
Oh, be quiet. And if you give him certain items and then reload the game or re-enter the world, he will trade, or he will have a different item in place of what you put down. So he gives out some pretty decent stuff. Let's go ahead and start with... if you have the Jade Hair Ornament, and you didn't give it to Stockpile Thomas, you get a Regenerator's Ring, which regenerates, I think, like 4 HP per second or something like that, which is really nice. But we're actually going to find one of those later in the level, so I'm not too terribly worried about it. That's why I gave the Jade Hair Ornament to Thomas. And by the way, you can't stack rings. You can't have two of the same ring, so if you could, that'd be great, but oh well. And now if you trade the Brass Telescope, you get the Fragrant Ring, which has the MP regeneration, aka the ring that the Royalty class started out with. I'm going to go ahead and trade him. Let's see, let's go ahead and trade him right away. Let's trade him our Soul Remains. You only need to give him one. But I don't really... Yeah, let's just drop one right here. By the way, you can only do each of these trades once per game. When you start a new game plus, you can do them again. But in a regular game, only once. And you can only do them one at a time, which is mildly irritating, but oh well. All right, so let's give him a Soul Remains.
Sparkly, happy.
Okay, that's how you know that he likes your item, and he's going to make a trade. Let's go ahead and... Yeah, that guy's running away, isn't he? I think these lizards only give cloud stones anyway, so I'm not too terribly worried about it. Yeah, let's drop down here, get this body. And a stone of ephemeral eyes, very nice. And let's go ahead and just load our profile here. Which, I think if you just load the profile, I think it doesn't respawn the enemies. I'm not entirely sure, but it didn't do it the last time I did. I think only if you actually leave the level is when the enemies reload. I hope. Okay, and it put me right back down here. Oh, wait. I didn't realize you could just stay at his tree. Okay, that makes life a lot easier. Okay, nice. I think the traps do reset, though. Like the arrow traps. So be careful if you reload the game too close to the entrance of the level. Alright, so we go up here. And our item is gone. But if we go around the side of the tree, here's our present from Sparkly. And he gave us white arrows for the silver remains. White arrows are the most powerful arrows in the game, but you can only get a limited supply of them. And by most powerful, I mean they do a nice chunk of damage right there. Let's see, the holy arrows do 150 magic damage, which can be resisted, and then I guess physical can be too, but compare 115 to 85, so that's a nice 30 attack power boost right there. Unfortunately, they are reasonably rare to come by, but oh well. Okay, now if you trade a Augite of Guidance with him, let's see, where is it? You're going to get 10 more. I got to unequip it. You can get 10 more white arrows. So let's go ahead and trade these in. Let's trade in one, because you can't trade in... I wish you could trade in multiple and get extras, but oh well. Okay, so Sparkly's happy. By the way, if you pick it back up, it's just going to cancel the trade because, well, he's not going to get his item. No, I don't want to load that one. There we go. This one. So yeah, Sparkly the Crow, very nice if you have the items for him, but if you don't, well, he's pretty useless. Luckily, most of the items are reasonably easy to come by. He does want some more rare stuff every once in a while, but some of that stuff I don't really care about, so I don't bother with. All right, more white arrows, thank you. I'm going, Sparky, hang on. Let's see, what else can we trade for him? Alright, let's go ahead and do some of the shard stuff that we can trade in. So let's trade in a shard of Mercury Stone here. No, dang it. I was trying to put it down, not recollect it.
Sparkly, happy.
Alright, thank you, Crow. And for this we get... Let's see, we get 10 full moon grass out of this. So, really nice deal. Especially since I'm never going to use that dang poison upgrade path anyways. If you happen to have a chunk of Mercury Stone as well, you get 10 new moon grass out of it. And new moon grass recovers all of your HP, which is really nice. And if you happen to have a pure Mercury Stone, aka the highest level, you get 10 dark moon grass, which recovers all of your HP and also gets rid of any status ailments. So, yeah, really nice stuff. Okay, calm down there, Sparky. Okay, so let's go ahead and give him a shard of Moonlight Stone now. And for this, I think you get more white arrows, actually. Let's see here. Oh, yeah. Okay, 20 white arrows. So, yeah, really nice.
Spockmort, give me, please.
Okay, be quiet, Crow. And then now if we trade in our chunk of Moonlight Stone, we get, I believe... 40 white arrows. I hope that counts, because he didn't say anything because I rolled off. Yeah, we get 40 white arrows, which is another really nice bonus. And if you happen to have a pure Moonlight Stone, you get an item called the White Bow, which is an item that can be upgraded with colorless demon souls, and it does pretty decent damage. It's not as good as the Lava Bow or the Spider Stone upgraded bows that I'm going to be using, but it is really good if you don't have, like, super high stats.
Give Spock me. Give me.
Okay, I guess this isn't going to count here. Okay, let's do it over here. But yeah, the white bow is pretty decent if you don't have the stats to use the other bows. But I don't have the pure whatchamacallits anyways. The pure moonlight stone, so I can't really do a whole lot about that. So, oh well. There we go, we should get our 40 white arrows. Alright, very nice.
What gift, please?
Alright, so now, let's go ahead and trade in. See, those are all the stones that I have right now. There are more stones you can trade in, but we don't have them yet. You get those in the 5th world. I'm not going to worry about the brass telescope for the fragrant ring trade, because I don't really care about the MP. Jade hair ornament, I gave that to Thomas already. Ah, here we go. If we drop off the silver cornet that I told you guys to bring along, we're going to get a storied hero soul, so that'll be really nice. And I think the silver cornet is, I think it's female only, and if not, well, it's mage, and I don't really care for it, so oh well. Storied hero soul, very nice. I'll take it. Okay, you be quiet now. And let's go ahead and drop off the silver bracelets as well. And I think for that you get another storied soldier soul. Oh, dang it. Will you stop picking stuff up? I'm dropping it for a reason, guy. Alright, so let's go ahead and grab that. And then we can trade in our Talisman of God that we just got and get something else for it. We're going to get another free Talisman of God later. And if we really can't find that one for some reason, we can buy it for 5,000 souls later. So I'm not too terribly worried about the one we have right now. Alright, so another story here, soul. And let's go ahead and... Shut up, bro. And let's go ahead and drop our Talisman of God now. And let's reap our rewards, shall we? And we get a colorless demon soul. Very nice. Very nice indeed. There is one more item we could trade in for a colorless demon's soul from Sparkly here, but we don't have that yet, which is unfortunate. But when we do get it, I'm not going to be able to use it anyways, so I'll just get it from... I'll just trade it into this guy. But we've gone through a fair amount of the Shrine of Storm, so maybe not a fair amount, but got through the first half at least and got a nice bunch of items out of it. So next episode, we're just going to go through more of it. I might meet you guys over at Blacksmith Ed to get our... bow upgraded, but we'll see. Anyways, guys, thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys next time. Have a good night.